All right, so meanwhile, the debate in Washington, D.C. continues over immigration and where reform is actually going to be picked back up is anybody's guess. But this is very interesting. The Think Progress had a video clip of Marco Rubio, basically about the Employment Non-Discrimination Act and whether or not gays and lesbians can be involved in the immigration bill. He said that he would get out of it altogether. But take a listen to what he said about the Employment Non-Discrimination Act.
Do you know if you'll be supporting that?
I haven't read the legislation, but by and large, I think all Americans should be protected, but I'm not for any special protections based on orientation.
What about on race or gender?
Well, that's established law.
But not for sexual orientation.
So Marco Rubio going on the record there that he's not interested and really hasn't even looked at the Employment Non-Discrimination Act, but isn't interested in being able to look out for people based on sexual orientation. And then we've got these tweets, and I wanted to get this in. We've got Jeff Flake's 15-year-old son in Arizona, Tanner Flake, who has been tweeting homophobic and some really nasty things. Jeff Flake has come out to apologize for his son because of what he said there. You can see the blurred out parts. It's the F word. But then we've got Joe Heck's son tweeting out. He's a 16-year-old. Joe Heck is a Republican in Nevada. We can show that tweet. It seems as if young kids are on the right anyway, and all around for that matter. You know, they're gonna do silly things. They're gonna make bad mistakes. But are we seeing, Cheryl, an entrenched homophobia on the right, that they're just not willing to recognize there's a sea change in this country? The Supreme Court is right now considering DOMA and Prop 8, and we should have that decision by the end of this month. Are they just unwilling to look at how this country is changing?
It is troubling to see that the GOP isn't keeping up with Americans. About 10 years ago, most Americans didn't favor gay marriage, and now that has completely flipped around, and a majority of Americans actually support gay marriage. 9 out of 10 Americans actually think that it is illegal already to discriminate against gays and lesbians. And so it seems like there's a double whammy here where the GOP seems willing to spike immigration, which is important to Latinos and Asian Americans, and at the same time alienate gays and lesbians, which will also alienate younger voters.
And when we talk about those younger voters, I mean, we get back to these kids of our elected leaders. I mean, so their dads are in Washington, D.C. You know, everything kind of trickles down. You would hope and think that they're having a better effect on their kids to be more accepting and tolerant in society. But Stephen, when we look at the fact that now I'm learning Tanner Flake's Twitter account has been locked. So his dad apologizes. Now they've locked it. So if he's going to be tweeting that stuff anymore, maybe it's just going to go to the people that want to hear it. It's like an echo chamber on Twitter for him. But I find it so funny that they've locked his account now, so you can't see maybe the homophobic or misogynistic or the racist crap that this kid wants to put out.
Well, I think that's right. I think that there may be an effort on the part of some of the parties to just try and pretend this doesn't exist, to just kind of tamp it down, lock down certain Twitter feeds, and kind of push all of this off to the side. But I think the reality is that the party has a real problem here. You know, College Republicans just last week published a report saying that young people, voters under the age of 30, want to see and expect to see the Republican Party become more tolerant when it comes to diversity, more tolerant when it comes to gay people, more accepting when it comes to abortion rights. And the party is just so locked into this culture war agenda, it can't break free. And I think we're seeing all this evidence that's showing that the party is very much on the wrong track when it's poised to lose an entire generation of